Hello everyone, Peter here, back on the topic of 1KD crack pistons again. Today I really want to run through why I believe they crack, why the injector gets the blame, and what we've done to help try and solve this problem. Traditionally, crack pistons have never been a Toyota problem. Toyota built a very strong reputation for diesel reliability on the back of things like the 80 and 100 series Land Cruisers, where 500,000 kilometres was just considered a normal operating life. So we know we're dealing with a new issue. And Toyota as a rule put out a great product. I drive a Hilux myself. I've just been lucky enough to be in the situation where I've seen literally thousands of 1KD pistons. I have personally assembled well over 1,000 1KD engines. I've been doing this for 31 years, so I just want to put my interpretation of this issue forward to try and help anyone that may need it. When I first got serious about trying to work this out in 2010, the thing I wanted to know first of all was, where does the crack start? What part of the piston? And what we found is the crack always starts around this inner edge of, or corner of the combustion bowl. You must remember that this is both the thinnest and hottest part of the piston. The other thing that it had in common is it always started in between the injection pattern. All the small cracks were always in between, never on. Okay, this pattern here is what's left from the result of the injector on top of the effect it has on top of the piston. So now we knew where the crack started, and those cracks you cannot always see. You can't just look in there with the borescope. We've washed these to find it, to see where the crack is, or whether it is or is not cracked. But now we knew where the crack started, the next thing I wanted to know is why. Why are they cracking? There has to be a reason. This is where common rail injection comes in, and this is where it starts to get a little bit interesting. When you had the 3L, the 5L, the 1KZ, these engines were fitted to Hilux and Prado models prior to the 1KD engine. You had a mechanical injector delivering fuel into a pre-combustion chamber. That atomized fuel was then directed out of the pre-combustion chamber into the cylinder for a controlled burn. With the Denso common rail injector fitted to the 1KD, there's 8 small injection ports in the end of the nozzle that injects directly into the combustion bowl at the top of the piston. So what we have is a piston that operates in a very high temperature environment, coming to the top of the cylinder, the injector opens and delivers that cooler fuel right around this little lip that we can see, okay? That gets directed, so that has effect on the top of the piston to create different temperature zones, okay, as we can see here. So hot, cold, all the way around the top. What this then does is create different rates of expansion. You must remember, in a high temperature environment, metal can only expand, it cannot compress, and it can only expand towards a free surface, which is in. So now we have a wedging effect. We have metal fighting for room. That is defined as thermal stress. That thermal stress now leads to thermal fatigue, and that thermal fatigue presents itself in the way of a crack. I believe a small fracture occurs as the piston cools down. Okay, so now we've established that. The next thing that they all have in common, and this drum here is full of nothing but crack pistons, and 100% of those will be cracked directly across the top of the gudgeon pin. Quite obviously, we've bored a big hole through here to put the gudgeon pin in, so now we have less metal here. This becomes the weakest point. The other thing is we have a pin, so as force is placed on top of the piston, that force tries to roll over the edge of that pin. So we have a piston that's effectively coming to the top. That force naturally wants to make it do that, okay? It comes down, it wants to do that. The deadly combination with the 1KD is the fact that we have the area that cracks the most lining up to the weakest part of the piston that is a pivot point for the force, okay? So you put the vehicle into a situation of high cylinder pressurization, you hook up your caravan, you head up a hill, whatever the case may be. Normally, you're putting that force, that's just normal operating force. All of a sudden now we've got a caravan on, we've got wind resistance, we're going up a hill, you push your foot down further. So that has to take a louder force. We know what happens next. Okay? That's why all of a sudden, without warning, you don't realize the crack is traveling. That's the end result. Okay? As always, if I can help or explain it to you more, please give me a call. The thing that I'll do next is I'll do a video on why the injector gets the blame. It's either an experiment you can do at home or at the workshops can do, whatever, just to see that for themselves. And then after that, I'll do a little bit more information or a lot more information on pistons and what we do. As always, as I say, if I can help, please give me a call. Thank you.